Our next guest shot to fame when his shocking Stranger Danger video went viral. We showed you it recently, and before we chat to him, let's take a quick look at this.
So if I go over to your kid right now, will he or she talk to me or run away?
I'm pretty sure she's not going to talk to you, but try.
All right, which one's your kid? I'm going to put it to the test. I'm going to go over there with the puppy.
She's right there.
She's right over there?
In the green jacket.
All right, I'm going to go over there and I'm going to talk to her as a stranger, all right?
Hi.
Hi.
Look at the puppy.
Puppy.
Look at the puppy. Like the puppy?
Yeah.
Can you guess what her name is?
Duncan.
Duncan? You were close. Her name's Donuts. I got some more puppies. Want to go see the other puppies?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. Come on. Right over here. Give me a hand.
It's absolutely shocking.
It just makes me sick to even watch it.
And with more than 8 million views, it's one of the most talked about videos of the year. And creator Joey Salads joins us now live from New York. Joe, thanks so much for joining us on Studio 10 this morning. Now, that video is incredibly shocking. Why did you want to make it?
I wanted to make it to put it to the test because I really didn't know what the outcome could have possibly been for something like this.
Were you surprised by the number of children who agreed to go off with you?
Yes, I was. Not one kid said no until I actually did the second experiment on an ice cream truck where one of the kids actually did say no.
So that's extraordinary that that every single kid said yes. Were you worried when you did it that you might have inadvertently been making, I suppose, a how-to guide for kidnappers?
I hope not. I don't think it's that way at all, because if it's this easy, I mean, kidnapper would know already. If a kidnapper really wanted to abduct a kid, they could have just easily done this without even seeing my video.
Sure.
Hey, Joey, how do you choose your topics?
I just try to think of something, you know, relevant, something that's not really been put to the test, something that could be potentially life-threatening, and just build something off of that to actually help educate people, like I did recently with my date rape social experiment.
Joey, you mentioned there that that date rape sort of experiment that you did. Perhaps you could explain for us what that involved. But I wondered if what you're doing is actually helpful, or is it just sort of voyeuristic?
I believe it's helpful because it's really easy. When I went to the bar, I actually did research before doing this video. And I went to the bars asking girls if they ever faced a problem like this. And more than so many girls, young women from, you know, ages of 21 to 28 that I've talked to have been drugged before. Luckily, none of the women I've talked to got date raped, but they have been drugged. And when I was actually leaving this studio last time, the driver, I pitched to him this idea about doing this date rape video, and he was like, yes, do this because my daughter got drugged once before, and this would be a great video to show the world, you know, that women need to really be careful when they go out drinking.
Joey, even here in Australia, it is a big issue at venues right across Australia, drink spiking. It was a really important video that you actually created. Let's take a quick look at that now.
I have something to go. Just watch my truck.
Yeah.
That was completely different. You know, it was a different atmosphere.
Never been
there. No, it's definitely different because
I don't know what it's
gonna be. Weather was good. No problem. No, I was just telling him about.
Don't drink that.
Why?
Because your friend wasn't watching, I was able to slip a drug and need a drink.
You kidding me?
I didn't do it for real. We got cameras set up and I'm doing an experiment to show how easy it is to drug a girl. Date rape and girls being drugged is a big problem.
Well, thanks.
So, all right, just be careful.
Good lesson for you.
Thanks a lot, man.
All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Enjoy.
Such a nice view, right?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, it is.
I wouldn't drink that drink if I was you.
Why not?
Because I just put a pill in it.
So, what are you doing here all alone?
Waiting for my friends, actually.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I wouldn't drink that if I was you.
Why?
Because I just drugged it.
Next time,
Just be careful. Put a lid
yeah.
on.
Yeah, this is crazy.
Don't take the drink out of your sight. Always keep it in your hand. Just
oh
so you can
gosh.
Stay safe, all right?
Thank you for telling me.
All right.
Joey, what's been the reaction from the public?
I'm getting a lot of feedback, a lot of thank yous from parents and young women to show how easy this could be. Because now I feel like I'm educating the world now on these experiments, and I'm really hoping I could make a difference through these videos.
Joey, what's the next topic you're going to experiment with?
I have a whole list of topics. I don't want to disclose any information about the topics because, one, I like them to be a nice secret, and two, I don't want to say something and then someone else goes and runs and does it before me, or a TV show, you know, steals an idea or something. So I'm trying to keep everything on the down low.
Right. So Joey, you say that you're doing this to sort of help people raise awareness, but do you actually make money from this? Is there some sort of other sort of something that you've got going on as well?
I mean, I do make money off of YouTube, but this new date rape video, I've chosen not to make any money off of it, unlike previous videos. And I mean, this all leads to, you know, the bigger thing, because after these videos, TV shows are hitting me up to do pilots for them. But I mean, whatever gets the message out there.
And Joey, I'm certainly all in favour of people doing shows like yours that are provocative and get people talking and stuff. But, I mean, one of the things that was said in the wake of the abduction experiment that, in fact, of course, people who abuse kids are most likely not to be strangers. They're most likely to be people known to them, tragically often even a parent or a step-parent or a guardian. We also know that, you know, in cases even of date rape and stuff like that, sometimes it's going to be the person that you're actually drinking with, not a stranger in a bar who comes up and slips something in your drink. And, you know, and there have been questions raised that sometimes it's just people having too much to drink and then saying their drink was spiked later on. Is it, and again, I'm not having a go, but is it not possible that there are actually really more troubling and boring problems that are going on in these areas that are actually more complex and harder to deal with, and that this is really just kind of the tip of the iceberg? This is just sort of the extreme end that is, you know, fun to watch and or does make an interesting experiment, but doesn't really tackle the problem.
I'm trying my best just to make the awareness and actually help and save people. I mean, that when it's like an in-home problem, when it's people you know doing these, you know, child abductions or these druggings, how can you possibly prevent something like that other than just paying attention and, you know, being cautious? That's the only way.
Yep.
Joey, you're starting a lot of important conversations, and thanks so much for joining us this morning. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Even when we talked in Studio 10 before about the attempted abduction with the children, it started a conversation with all of us talking about the importance of stranger danger with education with your children.
Yeah. No, I actually do think it's a good thing. I think, you know, I've done provocative shows like this as well, of course, but it's important that people know where these problems exist in the context of broader threats and threats that are much more real.
I think the message from both of them really is how easy it is.
Exactly, for it to happen.
Yeah.